be quite complicated is trying to say those two words more than twice at the same time. It's difficult. Normally, when we talk about criminal law, the application of criminal law, it's applied to acts which take place within a defined geographical territory or a jurisdiction by the governing authorities of that jurisdiction. So when we talk about Australian laws, we're normally talking about laws that govern things that take place within the country of Australia. However, you've heard reports and references throughout this meeting to countries which assert extraterritorial jurisdiction for the crime of human trafficking, and some also do for the crime of organ trafficking specifically, and Israel was a nice example of that that Gilad made. And what that means is when extraterritorial jurisdiction is asserted, those countries can criminally prosecute their citizens or long-term residents if they participate in transplant-related crimes, so human trafficking or organ trafficking, regardless of where those activities take place, in our home or in a foreign country. So if I try to buy an organ in Australia, I will be criminally prosecuted, I hope. If we had, which at the present time we don't, but if we had asserted extraterritorial jurisdiction for those laws in Australia, then if I go to Pakistan and buy a kidney there, then Australia can prosecute me within Australia under those same domestic laws. So why would we consider asserting extraterritorial jurisdiction for transplant-related crimes? Simply by asserting it, I think, has an incredible symbolic value. It indicates that a country has a commitment to uphold the shared ethical values and laws that address organ trafficking across the world. This is not one of those cases where Australia has a law prohibiting trade in a particular good, and Pakistan has a very different opinion. It is considered illegal to buy an organ in Australia, as it is in Pakistan, as it is in most countries throughout the world. It is also considered unethical to do so. The fact that there are markets in many countries, illegal markets, is not symptomatic of a support for this practice. It's symptomatic of the vulnerabilities of these societies. So by asserting extraterritorial jurisdiction, we are taking responsibility for the actions of people who travel abroad, for the impact sometimes of domestic policies, if Australia is reimbursing the costs of people going overseas to buy organs. That's something that we need to take, responsibility for. It protects domestic citizens who can be harmed by organ trafficking, and also foreign citizens. It says that our moral responsibility does not stop at our jurisdictional geographical borders. And practically speaking, if extraterritorial jurisdiction can be effectively implemented, it can facilitate transnational efforts by law enforcement to address organ trafficking and transplant tourism. It can help to provide a legal framework to support prosecution in settings or in circumstances where it can be just a little bit confusing or a little bit grey about who's responsible here in a legal sense. It encourages and supports the enforcement of law within the domestic jurisdictions. If everyone knows that people are leaving Australia to go and buy organs overseas, then that suggests that perhaps the laws we have in Australia against buying organs are perhaps not important. When we assert extraterritorial jurisdiction, it's clear we're taking this seriously. And it can deter participation in transplant-related crimes. I might believe that I'm unlikely to be prosecuted if I go to Syria and buy an organ. There are probably higher priorities in Syria than prosecuting me. But if I know that I could be prosecuted back home, I'm much less likely to go. So the bottom line, I think, is that if a citizen of a country that contributes to organ trafficking through exploitation of the vulnerabilities in other countries, they should and must be held not just ethically, but legally accountable at home. Thank you.
We now come to invited remarks, and the invited remarks are those of the residents and statute representatives of professional organizations. And our first is Jose Maria Simone, Dr. Simone from the Federation of the World Federation, Catholic Council.